Hello friends, welcome to my channel. Today in this video we are going to make this tulip pattern which can be used for making blankets, baby blankets, for table cover, table runner, and even for cushion cover. You can use this pattern for wall hanging and for paintings as well. I am going to use this pattern for hot water bottle cover. We have made this pattern out of small squares, and this pattern is very easy to make. The techniques that I am going to apply for this pattern are chains, single crochet and double crochet. So even a beginner can try to make this. So we are going to begin now. Things that we require for this project are yarn of three colors. I am going to use leftover yarn for this project. Needle, pair of scissors to use as and when required, and a hook that could match to the thickness of the yarn. Apart from all these things, if you need, you can use zipper for the mouth of the hot water bottle cover, or you can use buttons as well. So let's get started. At first, we have to pick up the tail of the yarn of color A, make a loop, insert the hook and pull through to make a slip knot. Now wrap the yarn on your hook, pull through, pull through, pull through, pull through, and pull through. These are 5 chains. We have to go back to the 4th chain, insert the hook in, pull through both the loops. This is slip stitch. Now foundation ring is ready. Chain 1, 2, 3, which counts as a double crochet. Yarn over, insert the hook into the ring, pull through. There are 3 loops on the hook. Pull through 2, pull through 2. Yarn over, insert the hook into the ring, pull through 2, pull through 2. 3 double crochet. Chain 2 for chain space. Yarn over, insert the hook into the ring, pull through 2, pull through 2. Double crochet 1, 2, and 3. When 2 sides of the squares are complete, we have to make chain 1. Now we are going to add color B to the pattern. To add color B, take the tail of the yarn and pull through. Now we have to make chain 1 with color B. Into the ring we have to make double crochet 1, 2, 3 with color B, chain 2 for chain space, into the ring 3 more double crochet for the 4th side of the square. Chain 2. Now we have to join these stitches on the top of the 4th stitch, so insert the hook and pull through both the loops. Now 4th round is complete. We have to turn the pattern, and into this chain space of 2, chain 1, 2, 3, which counts as a double crochet 2. On the top of next 3 stitches, 1 double crochet on the top of each stitch. Now into this chain space of 2, 2 more double crochet for this side of the square. So there are 7 double crochet for each side of the square in this round. Chain 2 for chain space. For the next side of the square, double crochet 1, double crochet 2 into the chain space of 2. Now on the top of next 3 stitches, we have to make 1 double crochet on the top of each stitch. Double crochet 1 on the top of the next stitch, 1 double crochet on the top of the next stitch, 1 double crochet. Into this chain space of 2, double crochet 1 and double crochet 2. Chain 1. Now we have to leave the yarn of color B and pick up the yarn of color A for chain 2. Now into this chain space of 2, we have to make double crochet 1, double crochet 2 with this color, and one double crochet on the top of each stitch of the previous round. So there are 5 stitches now, and now 6 and 7 for this side of the square. Chain 2 for chain space. Into this chain space of 2, double crochet 1, double crochet 2. Now on the top of next stitch, double crochet 1, on the top of the next, double crochet 1, on the top of the next, double crochet 1. Into this chain space of 2, double crochet 1, double crochet 2. Chain 2 for chain space. Now we have to join the stitches on the top of the 4th stitch. So insert the hook and pull through 2. Now we have to turn the pattern again and chain 1, 2, 3, which counts as a double crochet, into the same chain space of 2, one more double crochet. On the top of each stitch of the previous round, we have to make one double crochet. So in this round, for each side of the square, there should be 11 stitches. Now 2 double crochet for the 4th side of the square into the chain space of 2. Chain 2 for chain space into the same chain space of 2. Double crochet 1, double crochet 2. On the top of each stitch of the previous round, 1 double crochet on the top of each stitch. Now 1 double crochet on the top of the next stitch, 1 double crochet on the top of the next stitch, 1 double crochet on the top of the next, and 1 double crochet on the top of the next. Into the chain space of 2, double crochet 1, double crochet 2. Chain 1. Now we have to pick up the yarn of color B, and we have made chain 2 with this color. Skip this yarn and cut the yarn from here, because we are going to complete the square with color B. So cut the yarn from here and pull through tightly. Now we are going to continue with color B. So double crochet 1, double crochet 2 into the chain space of 2. On the top of each stitch of the previous round, we have to make 1 double crochet on the top of each stitch. So there would be 11 double crochet for this side of the square. 1 double crochet on the top of the next stitch, 1 double crochet on the top of the next stitch, 2 double crochet for this side of the square into the chain space of 2. Chain 2 for chain space, into the same chain space of 2, double crochet 1, double crochet 2. Now on the top of each stitch of the previous round, we have to make 1 double crochet on the top of each stitch. 1 double crochet on the top of the next stitch, 1 double crochet on the top of the next stitch, 1 double crochet on the top of the next stitch. Now into this chain space of 2, double crochet 1, double crochet 2. Chain 2 for chain space. Now we have to join the stitches on the top of the 4th stitch with slip stitch. This square is complete. So we have to cut the yarn from here and pull the yarn tightly. This square is complete. We have to make 3 more squares following the same pattern with this color. And we have to make 4 more squares following the same pattern with these 2 colors. So complete making 7 more squares following this pattern, 3 with this color and 4 with this color, and we will meet again when 8 squares would be completed. When these 8 squares are complete, 4 with this color and 4 with this color. We are going to stitch all these squares together. You can take a screenshot of this so as to how to keep and what should be the position of these squares. Squares should be kept like this. Now, to join these squares, we will take the help of needle and yarn, and now we are going to stitch them together. So this is how we are adding these two squares together. Look at the position as to how these squares are being stitched. So complete joining all these squares together. These are the 4 squares, and you have to stitch 4 more squares on the top of these squares. So complete joining all these 8 squares together, and we will meet again when these squares will be stitched together. When all these squares are joined together, this pattern would appear something like this. Now we have to join the yarn with slip stitch. Chain 1, 2, 3, which counts as a double crochet, into the same chain space of 2, one more double crochet. Now on the top of each stitch, we have to make one double crochet so that this pattern would be increased from all the 4 sides, and we will get the correct size for the hot water bottle cover. So we are going to make double crochet across the round to increase the size of this rectangle. So we have to make one double crochet on the top of each stitch until we reach at the corner of the rectangle, where we have to make 2 double crochet, chain 2 and 2 double crochet for each corner of the rectangle. So we are about to reach at the corner of the rectangle by making 1 double crochet on the top of each stitch . Now at the corner of the square, we have to make double crochet 1, double crochet 2, chain 2 for chain space, double crochet 1, double crochet 2 for the corner of the rectangle, and now we have to continue making 1 double crochet on the top of each stitch across the round. So complete making 4 more rounds following the same pattern, and we will meet again when 4 more rounds with double crochet would be completed around this rectangle. When these 4 rounds are complete, you can see this is the front part and this is the back part. Now we are going to make a circle for the top of the flower. So take the yarn of color C, make a loop, insert the hook and pull through to make a slip knot. Now we have to make chain 1, 2, 3, 4, join the stitches into the 4th stitch, so insert the hook and pull through both the loops. Now chain 1, 2, 3, which counts as a double crochet 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. Join the stitches into the 4th stitch with slip stitch. Now we have to cut the yarn from here because we are going to stitch it on the top of the tulip. When we have stitched this circle on the top of this tulip, we added a beautiful pattern on the top of the circle with simple stitches. Now we are going to join these two parts of the hot water bottle cover together. So take the yarn of color C and now insert the hook into both the stitches of both the parts, pull through two. Insert the hook into both the stitches of both the part, pull through two. Again, insert the hook into both the stitches of both the part, pull through two. So complete the round following the same pattern and we will meet again when this round would be completed. When these two rectangles are joined together, we are going to make edging for this pattern. So we are going to make chain 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now pull the yarn a little long into the 5th stitch, insert the hook and pull through twice and thrice. Pull through all the loops, pull through one. Now we have to pull the yarn a little long again and insert the hook into the 5th stitch, pull through two. Now we have to make chain 1, 2, 3, 4, skip 4 stitches, 1, 2, 3, 4, and join the stitches with slip stitch. Again, chain 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Pull the yarn a little long, yarn over, insert the hook in, pull through twice and thrice. Pull through one. Pull the yarn a little long into the 5th stitch. Come back and join the stitches with slip stitch. Now chain 1, 2, 3, 4, skip 4 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4. Join the stitches with slip stitch. Again, chain 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Pull the yarn a little long into the 5th stitch. Insert the hook in, pull through twice, yarn over into the same stitch, pull through thrice, pull through one. Now pull the yarn a little long, come back to the 5th stitch, insert the hook in, pull through two. Chain 1, 2, 3, 4, skip 4 stitches, 1, 2, 3, 4, into the next stitch, join the stitches with slip stitch. So complete making edging across the round following the same pattern and we will meet again when this round would be completed. When I have completed making edging across this bottle cover, I added zipper to the mouth of this hot water bottle cover and put this hot water bottle inside this cover. I kept the mouth open for charging my hot water bottle. And now this hot water bottle cover is complete. You can make blankets, baby blankets, table cover, table mats, and even wall hangings or wall painting using these squares. Thank you so much.